Chapter 2 discusses how successful global companies have continuously transformed the supply chain as economic and political circumstances have changed. The goal is to deliver the best value to the ultimate customer. There are several essential factors for economic growth and increased development of global trade flows. Some of the factors are population demographics, urbanization, land and resources, communication and information technology, and labor mobility, just to name a few. Those are major driving forces for globalization, and they need to be discussed in order to understand the future course of global trade and development. Global trade growth has been fueled by free trade agreements that lift most tariff quotas and fee or tax limitations on trade. The best supply chains compete very successfully on a national, regional, and global basis. The establishment of the General Agreement on Tariffs and Trade in 1947, which was replaced by the World Trade Organization in 1995, have led to multilateral trade promotions and lowered barriers to international business transactions. A growing number of countries have grouped together to form regional trade agreements. The best known example is the European Union, which started in the 1950s and growing up to 28 members by 2015. Given the importance of global trade to the United States, a delicate balance exists between security and the efficient flow of global commerce. If security is too tight, it could impede the flow of needed goods and materials, causing delays and decreasing efficiency in turn.